Bonecrusher were driving up, and then they just get into a fight. And the fight ensued onto another car. There's a
really skilled wrestler.
Doomsday going after Sample.
Whoa! Dutch. Nation of Dutch.
Disciples of Dutch. The Dutch
Wrestling Federation. Extreme Dutch Wrestling. And it ends up in Oiltrough, my hometown. You're covering your face up because of what?
I'm kind of embarrassed to be a Lawler fan.
You heard it. You heard it. I heard it. Championship Wrestling is on the air. Hello again, everyone. I'm Tony Friedman with a very special guest today, Bill Burns, our TV syndicator. Bill, welcome to the program. We have a huge show right here today on Championship Wrestling.
Oh, and thank you so much. Boy, it's great to be here, and you're 100% right, Tony. We've got a fantastic main event today. We've got the mighty Doomsday going up against the King, Jerry Lawler. And you know what? We're also going to have a full report on what happened last week. I'm sure you fans remember what went on in the parking lot between Brian Christopher and Billy Travis. Billy Travis been suspended, isn't even supposed to be here, and he's trying to get back in. We're going to have a lot more about that, I can tell you.
Also, the ECW's Tommy Dreamer is supposed to be here today. He has not made it to the building yet. However, we hope to have him here a little bit later on. Also, the situation between Dreamer and Jerry Lawler is escalated, Bill. It's going to break loose today, I have a feeling.
Well, you know, they just had that big fight at Hardcore Heaven, and now they're back here. Dutch Mantell's become involved because he's the holder of the unified title. No one really knows what's going to happen here. Lawler wants the belt back. Dreamer wants the belt. We're going to have to wait and see what happens.
Also today on Championship Wrestling, the tag team situation is getting very crowded here in the USWA. A new team has entered the scene, the team of the Free Spirit, Rick Titan, and the Spellbinder. They will be here in action against PG-13 today, and they've made it very plain they want a shot at those tag team titles. We have all that and a whole lot more today on Championship Wrestling. Want to be looking for you to stay with us. We'll be back to kick things off right after this timeout.
We'll be back right after these messages.
This summer, Caroline and Susan are bringing fun to NBC Monday.
She feels blue on a Monday night, and Caroline's there. She's gonna make your smile bright. And there's Susan, you know, she's that tall one.
It's like I'm little Susie Schwarzenegger.
Oh, girl, make Monday night fun.
Together on NBC Monday.
It's a four-day Labor Day sales blitz at Graceland Dodge. The big push is on with huge end-of-summer savings on every 97 Dodge. Save up to $2,000 on Neons, $3,000 on Intrepids, and $3,500 on trucks. Over 120 97s to choose from, plus a monster used inventory. Take the money and run with Chrysler cashback options, or super low financing could save you as much as $100 on your monthly payment. Hurry to Graceland Dodge this weekend. Still at I-240 and Elvis Presley Boulevard.
Dear Dave, when I saw Wendy's Smoky Bacon Cheeseburger was back, I said, that sounds good to me. So I got them for the whole firehouse. Some guys especially like the three strips of hickory smoked bacon, some the two slices of smoked cheddar and savory sauce, and we all agreed that we never had a hotter, juicier, more delicious bacon cheeseburger. Dave, come on by. We'll let you wear a big hat and ring the bell.
Dear Jerry, can I drive the truck?
Come into Wendy's and try our Smoky Bacon Cheeseburger today.
Now you can buy a nice car, too. Credit problems? No problem. Come to Schaefer Motors at 3360 Elvis Presley Boulevard. If you have slow, weak, bad credit, no credit, bankrupt, we can help. We have late model cars at prices you can't afford. Zero down with the trade-in. If you've ever been denied credit at any other area dealers, we can help. Down payment as low as $799 and approval in 1 hour. Come by 3360 Elvis Presley between Winchester and Brooks Road for a fine pre-owned car.
We're back on USWA Championship Wrestling. Tony Friedman here with our special guest today, Bill Burns, and we are ready to go with our opening bout today on Championship Wrestling. We told you at the top of the hour, PG-13 going to be taking on Rick Titan and the Spellbinder in this big match. And here they are making their way to the ring area at a combined weight of 572 pounds, the team of the Spellbinder and the Free Spirit, Rick Titan.
And you know, Tony, they had a big win last week. They're looking for another win here today.
We told you about the tag team situation being very crowded There are a lot of teams vying for the USWA Tag Team titles, and right now, making their way into the ring area at a combined weight of 442 pounds, wrestling out of the hood, representing the ECW, here are JC Ice and Sir Wolfie D, PG-13.
And, you know, they've got the hubcap with them. I see that they're bringing that to the ring like always.
One fall with a 10-minute time limit to kick things off today. The referee is Bill Rush. We're ready to go with our opening bout tag team action here today. All right, bell's gone, and we are underway. It's going to look like the free spirit, Rick Titan, starting things off for his team, and Wolfie D will start things off for PG-13. The fans here in the studio are solidly behind the free spirit, Rick Titan. If you're just joining us, fans, we have some stars returning to championship wrestling today that we have not seen in quite some time. Stars like the Colorado Kid. He will be here coming up a little bit later on. And today, the big return of Wildfire Tommy Rich.
Come get these jackets.
Oh, my God. Jamie just came over, threw stuff all over the desk. Already, we got a bad thing going here.
In addition, fans, to the Colorado Kid and Wildfire Tommy Rich returning, we have the ECW's Tommy Dreamer here today. He is supposed to be here. They've told me he has not entered the building yet, but Tommy Dreamer is scheduled to be here today from Extreme Championship Wrestling.
Boy, Titan's got Wolfie twice into the turnbuckles, three times into the turnbuckles. Big kick to the stomach. He's going for the...
The free spirit, Rick Titan, setting him up. He's got him way up there, gonna drop him with that big suplex. Ooh,
big, big suplex. I'll tell you, if they get a win here today, they're gonna really move up on those ratings. This is one of the hottest parts of USWA's, this tag team circuit.
The Spellbinder and the free spirit, Rick Titan, had a big win on last week's program, and this tag team situation is really heating up. You got about four teams out there all trying to get their hands on the gold. The Free Spirit, Rick Titan, and the Spellbinder, PG-13, Rex King and Paul Diamond, Stephen Dunn and Flash Flanagan. They're all vying for those tag team titles, Bill.
Well, I tell you, Spellbinder's a strong guy. It's literally threw Jamie all the way across the ring right here. I don't think PG-13's really going to be able to have much of a chance with this big, big, strong team.
The Spellbinder in there with J.C. Ice, one half of PG-13. He is being outweighed by about 100 pounds here and just out-muscled by the Spellbinder.
Well, you know, Jamie often gives away a lot of weight when he's in these matches and has always been competitive, but, you know, sometimes, well, I tell you, they just don't do it the right way.
J.C. Ice coming off those ropes, tried for the clothesline, but it had little effect on the massive Spellbinder.
Yeah, he's not getting much going here at all.
JC now with a drop kick and another one, having very little effect on the Spellbinder. He cannot get the Spellbinder off of his feet or do anything.
Jamie posing for the crowd.
Spellbinder has him over his head, press slams him down to the canvas. Wolfie comes in and he's gonna meet the Spellbinder's press slam. The Spellbinder rocking here today on Championship Wrestling, looking very impressive.
Go to break.
JC Ice looking for a little timeout. There are no timeouts in wrestling.
JC Ice wanted to take a break from this match. He wants to go to a break. We are going to bring you this entire match here today on Championship Wrestling. One fall with a 10-minute time limit.
Rick Titan back in the ring against Wolfie D. Lock up.
Double tie up now. Wolfie makes the tag into Jamie. Double team effort now going on. They're going to send him to the far side. Titan coming off and meets a double elbow. And now they come over and get a couple cheap shots in on the Spellbinder. And pandemonium is breaking loose in this contest. The Spellbinder on the outside of the floor with JC Ice.
Ooh, a beautiful fallaway slam in the middle of the ring, down for the pin. Bill Rush isn't seeing this. We don't have Bill Rush, he's got the pin. Rick Titan has the pinning situation.
The Spellbinder and JC Ice right around near us. Look out, Bill. Oh,
it's made it over to our desk here. Wait a minute.
Titan trying to get the referee's attention. He had Wolfie D down for at least a three count. And now setting him up.
Oh!
Oh!
Oh my God, Rick Titan had Wolfie up. Was
Wolfie
about to put him
Titan
down on the mat,
covered.
Was hit with the hubcap.
One, two, three, Wolfie gets the pin on the free spirit, Rick Titan. And PG-13 steals the victory after using that hubcap. The free spirit and the Spellbinder go down to the hands of PG-13. here in our opening bout today on Championship Wrestling.
And
fans,
again,
we still have lots more action to come. Coming up next, the return of the Colorado Kid. But right now, let me get around here. PG-13 stealing a victory today on Championship Wrestling over the Free Spirit Rick Titan. The tag team situation has become very crowded, and now you guys with a big win today.
A big win? This ain't a big win, idiot. This is another win for the greatest tag team in the world, who is none other than JC Ice and Wolfie D. So, you see, we got a lot of people coming to the USWA to take what rightfully belongs to us, the USWA tag team titles. Because if it wasn't for these two guys standing right here, this stinking company would have went out of business about 5 or 6 years ago. But luckily, two guys like us showed up, became the tag team champions. How many times? At least 13 times. Imagine that. PG-13, 13-time USWA Tag Team Champions. Well, when it's all said and done, whether it be liberty or justice for all, by the end of this week, JC Ice and Wolfie D will rightfully once again be the Tag Team Champions. Right, Wolf?
That's right. And all I got to say is, we're going to take some fools to school because we're cool like the water in the swimming pool. You might love us and you might not like us, but one thing's for sure, somebody's going to read these Nikes.
All right, fans, we have to take a break, but coming up next, we will have the Colorado Kid here today on Championship Wrestling. Stay with us.
Dennis Hall's Auto Salvage, home of a million parts. Call or come by 3100 Gill Road and see Dennis Hall's large inventory of both domestic and foreign parts. Bumper-to-bumper body parts used in rebuilt engines and transmissions. They also specialize in both new and used glass replacement for all makes and models of cars and trucks. For steering column and theft repair, Dennis Hall's guarantees the lowest prices in Memphis.
Hi, I'm Dennis Hall. For the best prices in town, come on down.
Oh, no.
How are you going to spend the last 2 weeks of summer? In this kind of sweltering heat? Let KFC do the cooking. Now through Labor Day, kick back with 10 pieces of your choice, original recipe, extra tasty crispy and tender roast chicken, 2 large sides and 4 biscuits, all for just $11.99. With a deal like this, you don't have to lift a finger. Just a leg, a wing, a breast, a thigh.
Everybody needs a little KFC.
Your move?
Hoodlum is filmmaking on a grand scale. Thrilling.
You don't back off, I'll kill him myself.
An electric 3-pronged attack. Spectacular star power.
You used to be a human being.
A hard-hitting drama reminiscent of The Godfather.
Man wants to be successful and he has to make alliances.
Better up! Fishburne is fierce, magnetic, irresistible, says the Los Angeles Times.
Get ready for your final thrill.
Yeah. Hoodlum, rated R, now playing.
Hi, I'm Suzanne DeFries, general manager of All-Star Chevrolet Geo Polaris in Olive Branch, Mississippi. I come from a hunting family, and Dad's philosophy on hunting is you've got to have the right equipment. That's why we took on the entire line of Polaris ATVs. Take the Sportsman 500, put it in the bed of this four-wheel drive truck, and you're ready for hunting season. I invite you to take that easy drive to All-Star. We're located on Highway 78 in Craft Road in Olive Branch, just 5 minutes from Memphis. I promise you'll like the way my family does business.
Back on USWA Championship Wrestling, fans, we have a VTR that we want to show you fans at home. Billy Travis and his downfall, Bill. It's taken place over the last several months. Our editors put some clips together. Here's Billy Travis and all this downfall that came about with Billy Joe Travis, the Sweet Music Man. Let's take a look at it.
Around with... Boy, I'm telling you... You are an idiot, Travis. He puts him right down at Travis with that guitar, hammers him under the chin, hammers him in the midsection, and now starts to attack.
Oh, my love.
Who's so bad?
The police are here, and they're arresting Billy Joe Travis. Now, who's behind this? This is ridiculous.
Get that camera out of my face! Luther!
Luther! Luther! Being let out of the studio.
Luther!
I don't know about this. I guess we will find out shortly what's going on.
As Travis goes into the corner, he's got something wrapping around his head. It looks like a chain. Travis looping it up on it as coming out.
Well, Binder's got his boot.
Yeah, he took his boot off. Hammers Travis. One, two, three.
My announcement today is that Billy Joe Travis is suspended indefinitely.
I've never seen a wrestler do this. Billy Travis is out there picketing.
Chris was driving up, and then they just get into a fight. And the fight ensued onto another car. There's a ticket for the USWA over to try to break things up.
Well, I'll tell you, that's Billy Joe just seems to be self-destructing here in the USWA, and I understand that he and I think he's outside again picketing the station, and James Beard may be out there with him. We're going to have to send it out there.
There's Billy Travis out there with that sign once again. He is picketing the USWA, trying to get back in here as a wrestler. He feels he was mistreated, and there is one of the officials of the USWA out there telling him that he needs to leave the property.
Well, he's holding a baseball bat, Tony.
I don't know what to make of this. We need to talk to James Beard a little bit later on or somebody out here to find out what's going on. We have a match in the ring to get underway here. Billy Travis out there in the parking lot. There's James Beard telling him to leave the property.
Well, I'm wondering about this baseball bat. I can't imagine why he's being allowed out there carrying a baseball bat on this station's property. They should get him off of there immediately. This is just a bad situation, Tony, that's only going to get worse.
They definitely do need to get him out of there right now with that baseball bat in his hand. He has no business being here at the studio parking lot today. They need to get him out of here. We have a match in the ring, ready to go. And Billy Travis interrupting things once again.
I tell you, I've never seen a wrestler self-destruct so dramatically as Billy Joe Travis. The man had everything, threw it all away, and now he's trying to come back, but really there's no reason for USWA to let this man back in. He's proven to be unreliable. He's proven to mess up all the time.
Right to be right here. If Channel 5 tells me to get off of this property, I'll get off. But by the way, you can't tell me. If you want to go call the police, man, y'all have dropped my step.
You cause any 100%. More problems out here, I will call the police. You understand what I'm telling you? Huh? What are you doing with the baseball bat?
There's Billy Travis having a few choice words for James Beard. We have a match in the ring. Downtown Bruno, the referee for this contest. One fall, 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from parts unknown, weighing 305 pounds in the ring, here is the Bone Crusher. His opponent, returning to the USWA today, wrestling out of Colorado Springs, Colorado, weighing 234 pounds, the North American Heavyweight Champion, the Colorado Kid. One fall, 10-minute time limit. Good to see the Colorado Kid back in action today.
Yeah, I agree. He's an exciting young talent, also a former USWA heavyweight champion. So it's going to be good to see what he can do here in the ring against a very tough big man.
It's been a while since we've seen the Colorado Kid.
And we're underway.
Collar elbow tie-up now. The Colorado Kid gets slammed into the turnbuckles. The Bone Crusher looks to be a powerful man and a roughhouser. Both men now sizing each other up.
Nice go behind, nice arm drag takedown.
Colorado Kid in control of things at the moment, just working on that arm. Downtown Bruno asks him if he wants to give it up. The Colorado Kid returning to the USWA today. The North American Heavyweight Champion now. The Bone Crusher takes the Colorado Kid over.
And you know, I still am not hearing that we've seen or heard anything about Tommy Dreamer. He's supposed to be here today. Quite honestly, I hope he won't be here. Last time he was here, I caught a bad end of that, honestly. So I'd be just as pleased if he never showed up. But I understand he is scheduled to be here today.
I agree with you on that, Bill. The last time I had an altercation with Tommy Dreamer, it was not a pleasant situation, and I hope he's not here today, but he is scheduled to be here.
And I'll tell you, between the King, well, and Tommy Dreamer, there's a ton of bad blood, and now Dutch Mantell in it, it's just going crazy here. A lot of nothing going on right now in the ring. Kid's ready for this big man to do something. He seems to be stalling. Kid's not taking any chances getting into this guy's arms.
They're going to lock it up one more time now. The Colorado Kid caught in that side headlock by the Bone Crusher.
Now, nice go behind. Almost into a takedown.
side headlock takeover. The Colorado Kid now has it in control on the mat.
You know, Gordon Soley used to always say they're all the same size when they get down on the mat, and this is proof of that. This, the Kid's taking him down, working him on the mat, trying to maintain control. It's important for him to keep doing that.
All right, both men back up to a vertical base now. The Colorado Kid gets forced into the corner. Still to come today, fans, we have the return of Wildfire Tommy Rich.
This is that
to Tommy Dreamer being here. Now the Colorado Kid gonna go to the outside, perched high on that top rope, coming off with that big sunset flip, count of one, count of two, and count of three, and that's gonna do it.
Well, I'll tell you,
the Colorado Kid gets the victory.
Real impressive win for the Kid, first time back against an awful big man. I'll tell you, just a heck of a job by the Colorado Kid. I think the Kid is going to come over here to the desk, spend a couple of minutes with us. Well, hey, Kid, great to have you back in the USWA, carrying the North American Heavyweight Championship. That's I bet you're looking for belts here in the USWA,
you
too.
You know, when the Colorado Kid's in town, I'm looking for the top, baby. All them USWA fans out there, you know who the Colorado Kid is. I want you all to come and see me. When USWA comes to your town, pack that house. Come on down, and you're going to see some exciting stuff.
I know we can expect big things from the Colorado Kid. Back now in the USWA, ready to get a belt out of this promotion.
You got it. I'm going straight to the top. Been there once, going to do it again.
Thank you, Kid. All right, now, we'll be back right after this break.
Oh. Stay tuned. There's more to come.
This one is big.
That's right, Clarence. It's the big factory-authorized clearance of big Ford trucks.
Hand them up. Move them out.
We are. Now only $239 a month can put you in an F-150.
Motor Trend's Truck of the Year.
Or get low two-down financing for 48 months and save over $1,600 in finance charges on a Ford Ranger.
And it's built Ford tough.
Yippee-ki-yay, little Clarence, and head on down to your local Ford dealer during Ford's factory-authorized clearance. Hit it, partner.
I'm crazy about a Ford truck.
Get it on at Greg's Store for Men. Greg's is all that and a lot more. It's the best place in Memphis to get your fashion on with the biggest brand names in the business. Get hooked up for school, a show, a special occasion, or for just chilling. Greg's is down with a large selection of shirts, shorts, jeans, caps, and all the latest athletic shoes and hikers. So don't take long. Go on and get it on at all Greg's locations.
Before we put the Exide NASCAR Select battery in your car, we asked a few volunteers to put it in theirs.
Ready when you are.
Let's do it, man.
Yeah, let's go do it. Don't be getting in my way.
Hey, what are we waiting for?
Exide NASCAR Select, the official battery of NASCAR. Specially designed and built to withstand blistering heat and vibration. Used on the track by NASCAR drivers.
Good battery.
Great battery.
And now available at an auto store near you.
When's the best time to get your new sport utility or truck? Right now! The Isuzu Rodeo. Right now, it's just $199 a month. 13 years running, Isuzu has built America's best-selling import sport utility. And right now, Rodeo is just $199 a month. Or right now, get $2,000 cash back on Rodeo. Pay just $147 a month for an Isuzu Hombre pickup. When's the best time? Right now, from your Isuzu dealer.
It's the four-day Labor Day sales blitz at Graceland Dodge. The big push is on with huge end-of-summer savings on every 97 Dodge. Save up to $2,000 on Neons, $3,000 on Intrepids, and $3,500 on trucks. Over 120 97s to choose from, plus a monster used inventory. Take the money and run with Chrysler cashback options, or super low financing could save you as much as $100 on your monthly payment. Hurry to Graceland Dodge this weekend, still at I-240 and Elvis Presley Boulevard.
I was in a serious accident and was injured, and I needed legal help. I was confident that Getty Keltner, Mivney, and Montese would take care of me because of their experience.
If you're injured in an accident, Gaddy Keltner Bienvenu and Montese's more than 125 years of experience can get you the money you deserve.
I would more than recommend Gaddy Keltner moving you and Montese to a family member or a friend ever in my situation.
This portion of USWA Championship Wrestling is brought to you by Bill Blake Auto Insurance.
Tony Friedman and Bill Behrens back here on the USWA. We've got more action coming up, but right now we thought it would be great for you fans. This is the last day that USWA Championship Wrestling will be on in this time slot here on WMC TV5. Bill's going to tell you about the new times in just a moment, but right now let's take a look at some exciting clips of past championship wrestling here on Saturday mornings on Channel 5.
This should be great.
We're gonna let it all hang down. After midnight, we're gonna chug a lug and shout. We're gonna stimulate some action. We're gonna get some satisfaction. We're gonna find out what it is all about. We gon' give an exhibition. We gon' find out what it is all about.
What it all about? What it all about?
After midnight, we gon' let it all hang.
Boy, I'll tell you, that piece brought back a lot of memories. You saw the big stars from the USWA, and by the way, everyone's been in the USWA one time or another, all the way up to the stars of today. And I'll tell you, that's going to continue in the future. We've got exciting news. You've been hearing about it. We are going to be having multiple time periods here in Memphis on WMC television. Starting next week, we will be still here on Saturday mornings creating great television, but we'll be showing that at midnight on Saturdays. That's midnight Saturdays. And on most Sunday afternoons, you're going to see us at 3 p.m. They're going to do their best to get us in around that busy NBC sports schedule. So you're going to see more USWA than you've ever seen before. And we think it's going to be a great, great improvement for this city and for this wrestling company. And Tony, I think you have some information on some of those upcoming cards.
All right, I do. Want to say, looking forward to coming to Midnights, starting next Saturday at midnight, USWA Championship Wrestling. Let's take a look at some of the places we're going to be visiting with live USWA action. Like Wednesday, September the 10th, we're going to be in Brinkley, Arkansas at the National Guard Armory. Doomsday, Brian Christopher, Dutch Mantell, Stephen Dunn, all signed, Brinkley, Arkansas, Wednesday, September 10th. Looking forward to coming back to Brinkley. Then from there, Lula, Mississippi's Lady Luck Casino, Thursday night, September the 11th. No wrestling at the Lady Luck this Thursday night, But we return on Thursday night, September the 11th, at the Lady Luck Casino. The King, Jerry Lawler, Brian Christopher, and a whole host of others all signed for the Lady Luck Casino. And wrestling action coming soon to Truman, Arkansas, Osceola, Arkansas, and Crenshaw, Mississippi. That's the USWA on tour. Make sure you catch it when it comes live to your area. Now then, we are about 36 hours away from one of the hottest nights of wrestling action ever to hit Memphis, the Big One Expo Center, tomorrow night, right here in Memphis. It all kicks off at 7:30, but one of those matches you're going to see is going to take place in the parking lot, and it's going to kick off somewhere between 6:30 and 6:45 when Brian Christopher takes on Billy Travis in a cage in the parking lot, free to the public. That match is free to the public, and it is unsanctioned, but as a result of what happened here, James Beard is going to go ahead and do it.
Yeah, and I don't think that's ever happened here. A free match, you don't have to pay a thing, just come out to the big one. Everybody come out to the big one this weekend.
The Rage in the Cage, Texas Death Match in the parking lot, Brian Christopher against Billy Joe Travis. No rules in this one, and it is unsanctioned. Let's take a look at some of the other action you are going to see tomorrow night right here in Memphis at the big one. The opening bout of the night will feature, let's get it on the screen.
Well, we got Bulldog Reigns going up against Rick Titan in that first match. Recon against the Spellbinder. We're going to have a USWA Triple Threat Challenge match, PG-13 against Paul Diamond and Rex King. The winner of this match is going to advance on to take on Flash Flanagan and Steve Dunn. Tony?
And then you're going to see a special challenge match with the King, Jerry Lawler, taking on the Madman, Rod Price. We've told you before that Jerry the King Lawler has a score to settle with Team Icon. He gets his opportunity tomorrow night right here in Memphis. Then the USWA heavyweight title match, the massive Doomsday, puts the title on the line against Dangerous Doug Gilbert. That is the USWA heavyweight title match signed for tomorrow night. Then the unified world heavyweight title will be on the line when the ECW's Tommy Dreamer tries to take the title back to Philadelphia when he challenges Dirty Dutch Mantel for the unified title. It's triple main event. There's going to be three title matches, eight matches in all, and it all happens tomorrow night. Bill, I'm understanding something's going on out in the parking lot. I don't know what's going on. There's Billy Travis again. Billy Travis out there with James Beard. He's got that baseball bat. We really need to get Billy Travis out of here.
Let's listen to what's going on here. I understand that Brian Christopher may have been trying to get into the parking lot and is somewhere in the area. I hope that's not the case. We don't need a repeat of last week's incident, particularly with Billy with a baseball bat out there.
Billy Joe's going to take this ball back.
Tony, you haven't seen Brian Christopher yet in the building, have you?
No, I have not.
And he is scheduled here today, right?
He is scheduled for an interview a little later on, and I have not seen him thus far.
This is not a good situation at all. Billy Joe Travis should be off of here. Oh, my God.
Well, speak of the devil, there he is. Brian Christopher coming in like a house of fire.
This is not a good situation at all. Oh, my God, they're getting into it on the street again. Last week, the police were called when this happened. We don't want this to happen again. And we need some help out there for James Beard, for sure. James Beard is not going to be able to handle this on his own. We need security outside immediately. Could security get outside? Billy Joe seems to be taken off.
Well, tomorrow night, right here at the Big One Expo Center, he won't be able to run from Brian Christopher because in the parking lot at the Big One, they are going to be locked inside of a steel cage in the Texas Death Match tomorrow.
Yeah, nowhere to run there. No baseball bat either. He's going to have to go in there hand-to-hand and take on Brian Christopher. Yeah, now that Brian has the bat, you see Billy's nowhere around.
I'm going to get up. It looks like Brian Christopher.
Yeah, it looks like
coming
Brian's coming
here.
Into the building, Tony. We may have a chance to talk to him here.
Too sexy Brian Christopher charging into the parking lot like on a house of fire. And he will be taking on Billy Travis tomorrow night in that Texas Death Match.
Give me that microphone. Get away from me. I said get away from me. Travis, I know somebody's going to tell you what I'm about to say, and I want them to tell you each and every word. It's just a few short hours. It's just a day away. You've been looking for me? Well, you'll know where to find me. I will be in the parking lot. You want it in the parking lot? That's where it's going to take place, in the parking lot of the Big One. Tomorrow afternoon, I'm going to be there waiting on you. They built a 10-foot steel cage. And Travis, it's just going to be me, and it's going to be you all alone in that steel cage before the matches ever get started. The sooner the better. Because, Travis, do you know what happens when flesh meets steel? You're gonna find out what happens when flesh meets steel, because I'm gonna grind your face into that steel until it don't look like anything but some bloody hamburger meat, and I'm gonna keep grinding. And I'm gonna keep grinding, Travis. You started this, I'm gonna be the one to finish it. You bringing these baseball bats for me? Tomorrow, I'm gonna have this baseball bat and a lot more for you, punk. You be there, because I'll be there waiting on you.
We'll be back right after these messages.
Just a reminder. It's closeout time at your local Chevrolet dealer, complete with the big savings and the big values you've come to expect. 97 closeout. See your local Chevrolet dealer today.
It's home cover-up time at Curlo Construction, and it's your chance to uncover big savings on the improvements your home needs. Right now, save up to $300 on Curlo's best 20-year asphalt fiberglass shingle roof. Save up to $800 on low-maintenance weather-beating siding. Call this number right now for a free, no-obligation home improvement estimate. And with 100% bank rate financing and no money down, Curlo has you covered. Take advantage of home cover-up specials from Curlo Construction, Memphis' number one home improvement company.
Hi, everybody. Ron Schiller's out here at Covington Pike Toyota. This is the big weekend, the one weekend of the year that everybody's waiting for. I'm talking the last weekend of the month and the Labor Day weekend. It is also the final weekend of Covington Pike Toyota's huge summer sell down. Everything is on sale. Over 800 new Covington Pike Toyotas all on sale. 97 Toyota T100 trucks. There are over 125 Toyota 4Runners. Look, the 98s are even here, and they're priced to move as well. The 98 Camry, is that not a sweet one? Even Toyota Tacoma trucks, plenty to choose from. You go into other dealerships, sure, they'll have one or two. Not at Covington Pike Toyota. The one you want is waiting for you right now with all the options. You just grab your title, grab your trade, and get in here. But you got to hurry. This is the last weekend, the weekend to take advantage of. Here to the last customer leaves, Sunday after church, and, of course, on Labor Day. So grab your title, grab your trade, get into Covington Pike Toyota. This is the weekend for you to get your new Covington Pike Toyota.
Back on Championship Wrestling, fans, we have another match to get underway. You are going to see today the return of Wildfire Tommy Rich. Coming up in our next match, Tony Friedman here with our special guest today, Bill Behrens, and he will be taking on Mike Samples, 250 pounds wrestling out of Lexington, Kentucky, in this one fall, 10-minute time limit match. Tommy Rich returns today, Bill.
And you know, Tommy Rich was one of the youngest heavyweight champions in this business and is still an amazing talent, a mature talent in this sport. Coming over to the desk saying hi. Pleasure, Tommy. Tommy's out saying hi to all the fans. You know, it's great to see Tommy Rich back here.
Wildfire Tommy Rich, one-on-one with Mike Samples here in his return today to the USWA. Referee calls for the bell, and we are underway.
You know, Mike Samples got a lot of trouble with this Tommy Rich. Tommy's a real... Well, wait a minute. Oh, I see. Tommy's coming out saying hi to all the fans, saying hi to us, and it's the Tommy Rich we remember from last time he was in here.
Tommy hasn't changed a bit. When he came in here shaking our hands and shaking the fans' hands, I thought he had changed, but not a bit.
And he's biting on Mike Samples right now, Tony. Come on. Bill, get this stopped. Mike Samples never had really a chance to get going here. Big, big, big elbow to the top of the head. Punch.
Tommy Rich now just choking him out with that boot right over the rope there. Referee laying the count out on him.
Oh, this is the Wildfire that you hate to see.
Once again, fans, I do want to let you know, scheduled here today is the ECW's Tommy Dreamer. He was scheduled out here today, and he is not in the building yet. But we are told that he will be here today. We don't know when he's going to be out here, but he will be here today, the ECW's Tommy Dreamer.
Samples thrown on the rope, caught with a big clothesline coming off. He's down. Tommy's really taking it to Mike Samples here. Oh, stomp on the fingers.
Wildfire Tommy Rich, the Atlanta, Georgia
native.
And
he's biting his ear. He's biting his ear.
Going to work on that ear.
You know, enough of this in sports. Enough of this.
Now just takes his fingers and slams them in the eyes of Mike Samples, gouging that eye.
Well, they've said Tommy Rich knows every dirty trick in the book, and those he doesn't know, he's about to learn.
So far in this contest, I haven't seen Tommy Dreamer use one legal maneuver. There was one. Took him over and now drives the elbow onto Mike Samples.
Well, I tell you, it's been crazier already today. You know, I'm hoping that Tommy Dreamer's not going to arrive here, because then it's just going to get worse.
So far, this match has been pretty one-sided. Tommy Rich in control of things, sends Samples to the far side. Samples gets the boot up, and that could be the break he is looking for. Samples now going to run with it to the far side. Catches Rich with the elbow.
Well, that Samples is a wise veteran. He knows when to pick his moments and get in, and it looks like now Tommy Rich is going to learn just how strong Mike Samples really is.
Scoops him up there and slams him down to the mat. Now laying those hard punches right into the sternum area of Tommy Rich. Perched on that second rope. Gonna come down. The fans here in the studio are solidly behind Mike Samples. Tommy Rich with the feet on the rope. 1, 2, 3. And Tommy Rich steals the victory here in his return to the USWA.
And he had his foot on the ropes, Tony. I saw his feet on the ropes. Bill Rush didn't see it, but I saw it. I think we're going to have the privilege of having Tommy Rich over here at the desk for a moment. Thought he had come back, was saying hi to all the fans, said hi to us, and I see
now
your...
That is wrestling at its best. I beat him right in the middle with a legal wrestling hold.
Tommy, your feet were up on the ropes. Everybody clearly saw that.
You're a liar.
All right, I'm a liar, Tommy.
Remember he raised my hand?
Yes, he did.
Okay. It's just like football, brother. They don't see everything the referee does. I want it 1, 2, 3, fair and square. My message is, though, a lot of people see me with ECW. A lot of people see me in Japan. But every time I come back to Memphis, Tennessee, I create a whole lot of havoc. There's a lot of things going on right here right now. A lot of them I don't like. Some of them I might. The bottom line is, anywhere I'm at, where USWA goes, when I say something's going to happen, it's going to happen. Whether I'm wrestling, whether I'm in the crowd, I'm back here to beat some people up.
Well, I think we've heard enough from Tommy Rich. Well, thought at first he was coming back to be there with the fans. It appears Tommy Rich has his own agenda going on now. I think we have another interview coming up here, Tony. If I understand that...
Here he is, the reigning unified world heavyweight champion.
Oh, it's the Icon himself.
Representing Team Icon, Dirty Dutch Mantel, here today on Championship Wrestling.
One thing, the tour has begun. The ABL Dutch Mantel 97 tour has begun. And I'm not going to be like the previous owner of the belt. I'm going to put it up against each and everybody, except one man, of course, the previous owner. As you can see, the ABL tour is in effect right now. And I don't care if it's Tommy Dreamer, I don't care if it's Brian Christopher, I don't care if it's Doug Gilbert, I don't care if it's Hulk Hogan, I don't care if it's Bret Hart. It don't make me no never mind. But let me tell you one thing. Dreamer, let me tell you something. You're talking about extreme championship wrestling. Well, you know, why don't you bring your big buddy Sandman with you? Having that
drunk the king has just come out.
Pound his head with a beer can and cut himself up. That's not extreme to me. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I mean, I think this is my interview, and I think he should be escorted out. Security should take him off right now. Obviously, he's not aware of the ABL tour. Anybody but Lawler. Did you know that?
Hey, yeah, I know.
I've heard you say anybody but Lawler until I'm sick of it. You can mention names like Hulk Hogan or Ric Flair or anybody you want to, but yeah, just shove it over here, Dutch. Let me just tell you the only reason I'm out here. Because you see, I know I'm not getting a shot until I go through Rod Price. I've already seen that in black and white. But what the problem is, Dutch, the problem is, yeah, why don't you step out of the way, idiot? You know what? You are useless out here. Totally stinking useless. Now, let me tell you something. The only thing you're doing, Dutch, and it's very obvious to me, and it's very obvious to everybody else, you're putting this belt on the line against Tommy Dreamer, and what's going to happen is Tommy Dreamer, and I know this from experience, is going to kick your hairy butt all over the building. Yeah, he will kick, yes, he will. He will kick your butt all over the building, and then you will lose that belt, and then I'm going to have to go back to that extremely crappy wrestling and get my belt back from Tommy Dreamer.
Let me say something right now. You think Tommy Dreamer can beat me? You know, you think he can beat me.
I don't think Tommy Dreamer thinks. I know he can beat you.
Okay, I guess I'm the only one who thinks I can win. Well, you didn't think I could beat you, Lawler, and
you
I did.
You beat me, Dutch.
Well, I got it, don't
you
I?
You didn't beat me. You, Doomsday.
Get up here, Barons. He's trying to threaten me. Security, come on out here. I'm going to tell you, if you've got such a problem, I'd give Tommy Dreamer a shot. You wouldn't even do it.
You oh got God, Tommy Dreamer. Dreamer has come out. Oh, God. Dutch has been thrown into the ring, and the King is on Dreamer. It's a three-way brawl all of a sudden here at USWA Wrestling.
Tommy Dreamer has arrived here today on Championship Wrestling and coming out after Dutch Mantell and Jerry Lawler, and now we're getting some help
out here. My goodness,
the
locker room is clearing. Tony, I knew this was going to happen, Tony. I was afraid this was going to happen. Dreamer is in on Lawler. They're holding Dutch back. This is all the way out of hand. We need more people out here.
The locker room has emptied. Once again, Tommy Dreamer has made his presence known here in the USWA. Over there, engaged in a big brawl with Tommy Dreamer is Dutch Mantell. Jerry Lawler trying to get over there and get a piece of him. Pandemonium has broken loose, and the locker room has cleared out.
Yeah, Tommy Dreamer came out with Beulah McGillicuddy, his partner from ECW. Okay, good. She's got him out of the ring. Hopefully, just get out of here. Oh, here comes Dutch again. They're taking it to the crowd. This is going to be dangerous. Everybody, get out of the way.
Tommy Dreamer and Dutch Mantell are in the crowd. We need to get some extra reinforcements in here. This should not be happening.
Move back over here, please. All right, this is going into the crowd. This is getting ridiculous here. We need more security immediately. Come on, we need more security.
Tommy Dreamer wreaking havoc here in the USWA, coming in like a bat out of hell.
We're trying to get them out of here.
Lawler.
Dutch,
taking
get out of here.
To Dutch.
Oh my God, Dutch has picked up Shoe Baby. He's got Dreamer around the throat. Dutch Mantell has Shoe Baby around the throat of Tommy Dreamer and is dragging him around the floor here at the USWA Auditorium. This is ridiculous. All right, we need to get this stopped. This is getting totally out of hand. Oh!
Oh, my goodness!
James Beard has just taken a real
Tommy
big
Dreamer
shot to the forehead.
Nailed James Beard.
All right, that's it. Somebody get... Beulah. Get him out of here. I'm getting out of the way. Oh, now Tommy Dreamer high-fiving the fans after going in the middle. Oh, Dutch Mantell is back out.
Back out here. Nails Tommy Dreamer with that Shoe Baby, the whip of Dutch Mantell. And once again, they are tangled up in a big brawl. Several guys out now trying to break him up.
Thank goodness they got James Beard out of here. This is just totally out of hand. I tell you, there's
Tommy Dreamer is a madman with his partner in crime, Beulah.
You know it's going to come to a head between these three people at some point, Tony. Oh, my God.
I swear.
Well, it looks like the things are calming down a bit, although the icon is still out here.
Dutch Mantell looks incensed. He wants his hands on Tommy Dreamer.
Looking over at us like, well, Dutch, it's not our fault all this broke down. You were the one hiding behind us. All right, we got to get out of here. We'll be back after a commercial break.
When's the best time to get your new sport utility or truck? Right now! The Isuzu Rodeo. Right now, it's just $1.99 a month. 13 years running, Isuzu has built America's best-selling import sport utility. And right now, Rodeo is just $1.99 a month. Or right now, get $2,000 cash back on Rodeo. Pay just $1.47 a month for an Isuzu Hombre pickup. When's the best time? Right now, from your Isuzu dealer.
Dear Dave, we were coming home from the track the other day and saw Wendy's Smoky Bacon Cheeseburger was back, so I bought a bunch of them for the boys. Man, was it delicious. Three strips of hickory smoked bacon, smoked cheddar, savory sauce, and sauteed onions. And they made them fresh when I ordered them, so they were hot and juicy. Stop by sometime and I'll show you the new car. Your buddy, Dale Jarrett.
Dear Dale, that'd be great. I'd love to take it for a spin.
He's kidding, right?
Come into Wendy's and try our Smoky Bacon Cheeseburger today.
We're Just Thrifty, the world's largest athletic shoe store, and it's time for our biggest clothing sale of the year.
The 50% off clothing sale.
Warm-ups, jackets, selected caps, jerseys, t-shirts, shorts, and more.
50% off.
Names like Reebok, No Fear, Adidas, Timberland, Fila, Logo Athletic, Wilson, and Starter.
50% off.
College and pro, we've got your favorite jackets and jerseys.
All 50% off.
And all shoes are on sale, too.
The 50% off sale.
This week, get Just Thrifty with the 13th pair is free.
You know, I've been in Memphis a long time. Bill Blake Insurance has, too. If you have never checked out the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance, then you're missing a Memphis tradition. Respect, service, and good value is part of doing business at Bill Blake Insurance.
I've been doing business with Bill Blake Insurance for years. He's always there when you need him, and you only have to make one payment per month.
I sing the blues all over the world, but I always come home, and I always see the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance. At Bill Blake Insurance, he's from Memphis.
We're back on Championship Wrestling. Bill Barron's here with me.
And things are cleaned up a little bit. Good thing no fans were hurt. Here we got a match in the ring, Tony.
All right, let's go to the ring for our next contest today. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, already in the ring, wrestling out of Los Angeles, California, weighing 289 pounds, here is the California stud, Rugged Rod Price. His opponent, wrestling out of Indianapolis, Indiana, 229 pounds, Flash Flanagan.
You know, I'll tell you, I think Rod Price now likes to be called the Madman, and boy, golly, I'll tell you, he has lived up to that. Flash Flanagan, go really taking it to him early in this match.
Flanagan coming off that second rope, tried for the high cross body press, but Price slams him down.
Oh my gosh, what a power slam. That Flash, I'll tell you, Flash Flanagan, though, is one of the real up-and-coming superstars in professional wrestling. Big, big backdrop there.
I'm still trying to catch my breath after what just happened with Tommy Dreamer, that he's a madman. He's incensed over Dutch Mantel, Jerry Lawler. He wants to get his hands on both of them, and I hope that's the last we've seen of him today. I really do.
I do also. I'm just glad he didn't get over into us this time, Tony. He's got Flash tied up in the rope, and he's taking those knees into the stomach. A referee needs to break this up, Tony. Now he's got his foot down there on the throat. Flash is in some real trouble here, tied up like he is. Got to get that foot unhooked. Oh, good.
Rod Price has really come on strong since entering the USWA several weeks ago. Now in control, and Flanagan sends him to the ropes, catches him with that knee to the midsection. Price sensing victory now.
Got him in a crossbow kind of move, putting a lot of pressure on the shoulders and the arms right here. This could be a submission move if it's applied with enough force, and certainly Rod Price has that kind of strength. Big forearm across Flash's chest. Flash trying to fight back, punches and forearms to the mid, but just not doing anything. Rod Price isn't feeling any of those.
Now Price over there choking out Flanagan. Referee Downtown Bruno laying the count out on Price. Flanagan trying to fight back, but that kick had very little effect on Rod Price. Now going to set him up. Drapes him over the ropes. Looked like he was going for a suplex, but he took him and draped him right over the ropes.
I thought that was going to slingshot suplex. He dropped him right on the rope, right on the stomach. He's really been doing moves to take the wind out of Flash Flanagan, and that is one of the ways to get a man down for the three count.
Catches him with that big power lariat. Man.
I tell you, Flash nearly knocked out of his shoes on that one. Crowd has really picked up the chant for Flash Flanagan here. I tell you, he is a fan favorite, and with them behind him, I have a feeling you're going to see Flash get more into this match in just a second.
Snap mare now. just gouging at the face of Flanagan. We saw this earlier from Tommy Rich. These rule breakers, they come in here and they take any opportunity they can to break the rules.
Just ignore the rules, I'll tell you. It's almost like they didn't exist sometimes. Got Flash into the corner, forearms. About to sling him into the opposite ring corner. Oh, Flash is able to move, and Price may have caught his shoulder on that ring post. I couldn't get it from my angle, Tony.
Flanagan now, snap bears him over. Whips the neck of Rod Price. Flanagan now has things going his way.
That's smart, working on the head and working on the neck, softening up the big man. That's very important.
Flanagan has turned things around to his advantage. Gonna send Price, Irish whip into the corner, catches him in the midsection with that boot, and a beautiful leg scissors over and under.
Boy, that's a beautiful hurricanrana that he just took him over with there. He's going to the top rope now.
Flanagan, set up, perched high up on that top rope.
And he met a
huge power slam. Make it one, make it two, and make it three.
Oh, man. A tough loss for Flash Flanagan. He really had him going at the end there, caught in that big power slam. And I tell you, Rod Price is an impressive, impressive wrestler.
Rod Price gets the victory in this match, and he's going to come around to talk to us. Rugged Rod Price, the madman, whatever you want to call him, gets the victory, and he has been on a rampage since entering the USWA several weeks ago. Rugged Rod Price with a victory today against Flash Flanagan.
Let me tell you something. Lawler, Brian Christopher, I don't care. I just don't care anymore. It's so much in my head. Every night I wake up, I dream. Just like you, Lawler, you got a dream? So do I. Kicking your hind in. That's my dream, and it's going to happen real soon.
Well, I'll tell you, Jerry Lawler's got something to think about now. He's got Rod Price going after him. He's got that thing going with Dreamer. And I don't know. I wouldn't want to be Jerry Lawler right now with Dutch, Dreamer, Rod Price. But I do have some good news right now for the fans. I've got a big surprise for the fans right now. For the last few weeks, we have been in serious trouble here. Well, here's a really big surprise here. Lovely Stacy is heading out to join us. Well,
thank you.
We've got somebody you all know on the telephone. We've been wondering how he's doing. I wonder, Lance Russell, are you there?
Bill Behrens, how you doing, partner?
Well, more important, Big Lance, how are you doing, buddy?
Well, I'm just doing as well as anybody in the world could expect. I've been so fortunate and blessed with all of the people that have had us in their prayers and their wishes. And it looks like we're coming back from that operation and doing better than we thought at this point, Bill. Yeah, I can tell you one thing. Action has not slowed down in the USWA.
Oh, you're right about that, Lance, always.
Hi, Stacy.
Hi, Lance.
Hi,
how are
Tony.
You?
Hello, Lance.
I miss you.
Well, I appreciate that very much, and I miss being there. I just want to take this second, if you'll let me, to say to all of the people out in the USWA land, I cannot tell you how much we appreciate the thoughts and the expressions that we've gotten from folks all over the USWA territory, and I mean every state that we are going into. It just stuns us, the number of cards that have come in. We appreciate your wishes, and we're looking forward maybe to being back there with you at some point down the line. Looking forward to that.
Nothing would make us happier, Lance, than to have you here at the desk, particularly with this stuff going on with Dreamer,
yeah.
Lawler, Dutch. We need you out here.
Hey, I think I'd rather be right where I'm looking at it now, being where you and Tony are right in the middle of it out there. That's for a fact.
And I'll tell you, it does keep it interesting out here.
Yeah.
Stacy, you might have something to say to Lance.
I just want to tell him that I miss him, and I hope he comes back soon.
Well, we're working on trying to get ourselves in position where we're going to be able to be back. And things are better, I think, at this point than we really thought that they were going to be. And so that means we may be ahead of schedule, and we'll just have to see how it goes. I miss all of you folks, and I miss all of the USWA fans, and am really looking forward to the first opportunity we can to get back to it.
Lance, get well soon, and we'll be seeing you down the road. I cannot wait to have you back right here at the desk on Championship Wrestling. Lance, good to hear from you. Want to say get well, and we have more Championship Wrestling coming up right after this timeout.
one is big.
That's right, Clarence. It's the big factory-authorized clearance of big Ford trucks.
Hand them on. Move them out.
We are. Now only $239 a month can put you in an F-150.
Motor Trend's Truck of the Year.
Or get low two-down financing for 48 months and save over $1,600 in finance charges on a Ford Ranger.
And it's built Ford tough.
Yippee-ki-yay, little Clarence, and head on down to your local Ford dealer during Ford's factory-authorized clearance. Hit it, partner.
I'm crazy about a Ford truck.
Snapper, America's number one rear-engine rider. With the legendary Snapper rear-engine rider, your lawn never had it so good. Our pivoting articulating frame lets the deck conform to your lawn for a smooth, even cut every time. Right now, you can take home America's number one rear-engine rider or any mower in Snapper's line at the lowest prices of the year during Snapper's factory-authorized end-of-season clearance sale going on now. Every model is on sale, but they won't last long, so what are you waiting for? Call your local Snapper dealer today.
We're building a higher level of excitement. Gold Strike Casino Resort. Call 1-888-24K. Stay.
It's the biggest football game of the year, the 8th annual Southern Heritage Classic. The Jackson State Tigers and the Tennessee State Tigers take to the gridiron. The Clash at the Classic, Saturday, September 13th, 7 p.m. at the Liberty Bowl. Tickets on sale at all area Ticketmaster outlets, including selected Piggly Wiggly stores. Charge by phone at 525-1515. Sponsored by the following sponsors and WMC-TV5. 8 will be great.
When you go to get a new muffler, some places treat you like a dog. First, you gotta perform tricks to even get them to work on it. Then they make you roll over and play dead while you wait for them to finish. And when the bill comes, you better beg for mercy. Not at Meineke. At Meineke, you'll always get a high-quality muffler and professional, no-nonsense service fast. In fact, you may want to shake their hand.
Good boy, Rusty.
At Meineke, you're not gonna pay a lot, but you'll get a lot.
I guarantee it. What?
Exclusively on Action News 5.
Tony Friedman back on the USWA with Bill Behrens. We have loads of more action coming up today here on Championship Wrestling. Right now, Dangerous, Dark Gilbert, making his way out to ringside. We're going to get the opportunity to talk with Dangerous Doug Gilbert about the big match he will be engaged in tomorrow night right here in Memphis Town when he challenges the massive Doomsday for the USWA heavyweight title. Action kicks off tomorrow night at the big one, 7:30 p.m., and this man has the USWA heavyweight title shot tomorrow night against Doomsday.
You know what? I've listened to a lot of people talk, and it's made me think back about history. History of the USWA. Ever since I was a small kid, I used to ride down to Memphis, Tennessee, to the Mid-South Coliseum. I'd ride down and watch my dad, Tommy Gilbert. I'd watch Jerry the King Lawler. I would watch Austin Idol. I'd watch superstar Bill Dundee. I'd watch all the greats. Now, let me tell you something. This Sunday, I don't know if the people actually realize it. It's been 2 long years since Dangerous Doug has walked into Memphis, Tennessee and put on a pair of wrestling socks. What that means, Tony, see what it is, you've got Jerry Lawler, you've got Tommy Dreamer, and you got Dutch Mantell all out here rolling around like a bunch of monkeys. Well, let me tell you what's going to happen, boys. Whatever happens in the world title chase, I'm going to be the number one man on your trail, because see what I've got tomorrow at the Big One Expo Center right here in Memphis, Tennessee, is I have got a USWA title match. And I don't know if you know it, Tony Friedman, or not, but I am a former six-time USWA heavyweight champion. Now, let me tell you something about the Big One. The Big One's one of the best facilities in town that you can come down to. It's got a good cold air conditioner, right? Well, let me tell you something, Tony. When it gets time for me, the air conditioner ain't gonna help, because so help me God, Doomsday, I will set your ass on fire before I leave Shelby County.
Dangerous Doug Gilbert tomorrow night will be challenging for the USWA heavyweight title. I cannot wait to be ringside for that one, Bill.
I would agree with you, and I will be there. I want to see that match and all the other ones at the Big One that are coming up. But we got to talk about some of the other cards coming up here in the USWA, don't we?
USWA on tour. Want to hit it real quick, and then we'll tell you about all the action taking place tomorrow night at the Big One. The USWA on tour, Brinkley, Arkansas, Wednesday, September the 10th, at the National Guard Armory. You will see the massive Doomsday, Too Sexy, Brian Christopher, Dirty Dutch Mantel, Stephen Dunn, among others, Wednesday, September 10th in Brinkley, Arkansas.
All that at 7:30 p.m., by the way.
That is correct. Then Lula, Mississippi. We return to the Lady Luck Casino Thursday night, September the 11th. Bell time at the Lady Luck Casino is always 8 p.m. Thursday night, September the 11th. Jerry the King Lawler, Brian Christopher, and a whole host of others Thursday, September 11th at the Lady Luck Casino. Now, let's get right into it. Memphis, Tennessee. Oh, I'm sorry. Coming soon, Truman, Arkansas, Osceola, Arkansas, and Crenshaw, Mississippi. I was getting a little excited there. You have to get excited when you're talking about Memphis, Tennessee. Tomorrow night, the Big One Expo Center. It's all going to break loose, Bill.
I'll tell you, we've got with the main events that we have in this, I can't imagine a bigger card anywhere at this point.
Ticket prices tomorrow night for the big show will be $10 ringside. General admission is $8, and kids under 10 get in for just $5, a great value for the whole family. You're going to have a special autograph session tomorrow. Call for the number, this number for tickets, 276-3532, 276-3532, and free USWA merchandise will be given away during the evening to some of the fans there, so it's a great value for the whole family.
And we have that free match right in front of the Big One, don't we?
That's right, the Rage in the Cage. Billy Joe Travis going to be in there with Brian Christopher. We'll get into that in just a moment. Let's take a look at the entire card tomorrow night at the Big One Expo Center. Opening bout of the night, you're going to see the Spellbinder taking on Tommy Rich. Then from there, Bulldog Reigns tangles with the Free Spirit, Rick Titan. USWA Tag Team Qualification Match, PG-13, take on Paul Diamond and Rex King. That's going to be a good one. Then the Texas Death Match. This is the one that's going to take place in the parking lot before the show. It's going to be the Texas Death Match. Too Sexy, Brian Christopher, and Billy Joe Travis. And they've told me it's going to get underway somewhere between 6:30 and 6:45. And this match,
I'd get there early, because I don't think that Brian Christopher is going
to
wait.
No, he's not. And this match is absolutely free to the public, and it will get underway before our regular bell time of 7:30 at the Big One. Then from there, you're going to see the USWA Tag Team title, the conclusion of the Triple Threat match, when Dunn and Flanagan take on the winner of PG-13 against Diamond and King. That's for the Tag Team titles. That's going to be a great match. And then you're going to see Jerry the King Lawler. He has a score to settle with Team Icon. He gets his opportunity tomorrow night at 7:30 at the Big One against Rod Price in the special challenge match. Then, the match we were just talking about, USWA heavyweight title on the line, the massive Doomsday defends against Dangerous Doug Gilbert. That's not all the action, though. The main event of the night, the one everyone is waiting for, the ECW's Tommy Dreamer has come in here to challenge Dirty Dutch Mantel for the Unified World Heavyweight title, and Tommy Dreamer is a man on a mission, and he gets his opportunity tomorrow night.
And I bet you the King's going to be at ringside for that match for sure.
All right, we are going to jump in and take a break real quick.
No, I think we got something coming on here. We got an interview coming up with a legend in this area. That would be Superstar Bill Dundee. Do we have that tape?
Superstar Bill Dundee, a man we haven't heard from. They told me we're going to go ahead and show you that interview right now. Here's the Superstar Bill Dundee.
How's that? That water should be back. Hey, listen. Guess where we're going to be Sunday?
Where are we going to be?
We're going to be at the Big One.
We are?
Ask me why.
Why are we going to be at the Big
because
One?
Because James Beard called, and that's the promoter of the USWA.
He did?
Yes, he did. And you know what he told me? What
did he tell
me? He said, Superstar, we have a match between Tommy Dreamer and Dirty Dutch Mantel for the Unified Heavyweight Belt.
He did?
He sure did. He said, and I'd like somebody to referee it right there in the middle, because it may get out of hand. Ha! I'm the man. That's right. Tommy Dreamer, ECW, never seen it up close, don't know nothing about it. They say you're big and you're bad. But I used to think Memphis wrestling was big and bad for the last 20 years. Whatever could be done, we'd done it. And Dirty Dutch Mantell, I don't care much for you at all, boy. I have had Shoe Baby across my back 100 times, and I never liked it, and I don't particularly care for you. But you're the champion. You beat... you know who he beat? Jerry Lawler.
Jerry Lawler.
And you know what's doing to Lawler?
What's it doing?
Driving him nuts.
Nuts.
Somebody told me he was going to buy a ticket and be ringside because he doesn't want Dutch Mantell to lose his belt.
He wants to buy a ticket?
How can it be his belt? Mantell's the champion, right? So, Tommy Dreamer, let me tell you something, brother. If I tell you something, it'll happen. If you beat Dutch Mantell, get his shoulders down, I will count. 1, 2, 3, and you'll be the champion. But if he gets you down and your shoulders are on the mat, I'm going to count. 1, 2, 3, and he'll be the champion. So, Jerry Lawler, if you've told the whole world that you're buying a ticket and you're going to be ringside, you better stay ringside. And I'm telling you, boy, don't stick your nose in this. You're not making a fool of me and you're not making a fool of Memphis. You're going to sit ringside because you're buying a ticket and you better stay ringside. Like I said, Mantell and Dreamer, whoever wins, I don't care. I don't care if you half kill one another. The man asked me to be the referee and I'm going to referee fair and square. Whoever's down, I'm counting. See you boys at the big one.
Well, you just heard it. Superstar Bill Dundee will be in the ring as the third man for the match between Dutch Mantell and ECW's Tommy Dreamer, and I guarantee you, oh my God. Coming out to the desk is Tommy Dreamer and Beulah McGillicuddy. Tommy, nice to see you again.
Do me a favor, because you guys are about as worth, you're a piece of furniture. You and you, hold this banner up. Hold the banner, hold the banner. Come here, Beulah. Hold the microphone. Let me get one thing straight. Superstar Bill Dundee is a special referee. Jerry Lawler's in the audience. I'm wrestling Dutch Mantell. Hey, Beulah, why don't they just handcuff Austin Idol right to your wrist? They could bring Joe LeDuc back, cut off my arm with the axe. And hey, why don't you just throw back Jackie Fargo and he could be a chairman or something, you know? You guys here, hold that banner up tight or I'll knock you both out. That's my flag, all right? That's right, buddy, ECW. Plain and simple. The old-timers here don't want the new revolution to take over, but tomorrow night in Memphis, we're taking over.
Well, that's what Tommy Dreamer may be saying. I don't think that's going to happen. I hope Dutch Mantell takes it. First time I'll probably ever say that.
Tomorrow night, 7:30 p.m. at the Big One Expo Center, Tommy Dreamer and Dirty Dutch Mantell for the unified title. I cannot wait for that one.
Wait a minute. Looks like Jerry Lawler's trying to get out here and has been restrained this whole time from coming out. You had to think that Lawler was going to try to get out here with Dreamer.
Bill, you take this. I don't want to.
Well, I'm not sure I want. Jerry, he's already gone, Jerry. He's already gone.
Back out here, huh? Hey, Tommy Dreamer.
I'm not sure I want him out here.
Yeah, well, I do want him out here. I'd like to have Tommy Dreamer, I'd like to have Dutch Mantell, and I'd like to have that little sawed-off idiot Bill Dundee out here. Now, is it not obvious to everybody what's going down here? Huh? Dutch Mantell couldn't beat Tommy Dreamer on his best day. Now, Dutch, not only, I guess you went out and got Bill Dundee to be the special referee thinking he's going to help you. Well, let me tell you something, Dutch, you idiot. Bill Dundee is not going to help you. Bill Dundee hates you. Bill Dundee hates me because Bill Dundee is eat up with jealousy. You saw what he stuck with, didn't you? You saw that hey, I will wish she would raise her arms up again so all that big fat could hang down more and flap in the wind. That's what has happened to Bill Dundee's life. That's why he's jealous of somebody like me. He's jealous of somebody like Dutch Mantell, who now has a title. And Dutch, you think he's going to help you? He is not going to help you. And I'm going to tell you, the only thing that might save you, Dutch Mantell, is me buying a ticket and being at ringside to assure that you don't lose my title. Dutch Mantell, you ought to come out here and get down on your stinking hands and knees and thank me, because I am the only hope that you have of keeping that belt right here in Memphis. Tommy Dreamer, I want you to know something. Bill Dundee, I want you to know something. That unified World Heavyweight Championship belt had better not leave Memphis, Tennessee tomorrow night. You understand me?
Well, I tell you, I'm worried like just like the King is. I hope he's also focused on his match because he has a big match at the big one also. He could get distracted by this other. We're going to have to go to break. I will be right back.
A freak summer snowstorm has dumped nearly a foot of snow on Covington Pike Chrysler Plymouth, Memphis.
And we have to clear the lot to make room for the snowplows.
New 1997 Covington Pike Plymouth Voyages are on sale now from just $15,777. That's right, only $15,777 for a new 97 Voyager minivan with air, automatic, and seven-passenger seating.
At Covington Pike Chrysler, we have the coolest deals in Memphis.
Covington Pike Chrysler Plymouth on Covington Pike.
Dennis Hall's Auto Salvage, home of a million parts. Call or come by 3100 Gill Road and see Dennis Hall's large inventory of both domestic and foreign parts. Bumper-to-bumper body parts, used and rebuilt engines and transmissions. They also specialize in both new and used glass replacement for all makes and models of cars and trucks. For steering column and theft repair, Dennis Hall's guarantees the lowest prices in Memphis.
Hi, I'm Dennis Hall. For the best prices in town, come on down.
You work hard, so when it's time to play, do it with style at the Beale Street Labor Day Music Festival. Beginning Sunday, August 31st at 5 p.m., a $15 wristband gets you into 12 clubs. That's 12 clubs featuring some of the best live music on the planet. And the party doesn't end until 5 a.m. the next day. That's 12 hours, 12 clubs for just $15 at the Beale Street Labor Day Music Festival, Sunday, August 31st.
Covington Pike Toyota, that's where you need to be this weekend. As a matter of fact, you need to be here today because these are blowing out the door. And why? They're priced to move. Look at this. A 1997 Toyota Corolla. It's demo sale priced at $13,790. Air automatic. It's loaded. How about a 98 Toyota Tacoma pickup truck 4x2, $11,490. Just a couple of the prices you'll find. Some great sales going on here this weekend. Here the last customer leaves tonight, Sunday after church, Covington Pike Toyota. You know where it is.
Back on the USWA fans, we've got more action. Let's go to the ring. Making his way to the ring area, wrestling out of Atlanta, Georgia, weighing 239 pounds, here is Rex King.
And coming
his opponent, making his way to the ring area, wrestling out of Hendersonville, Tennessee, Stephen Dunn.
Tell you, there's an awful lot of heat between these two guys. These are former partners. Rex King came in here under a mask and started to go after Steve Dunn. They used to be part of a tag team in the World Wrestling Federation, and now they are bitter enemies.
Former partners doing battle today on Championship Wrestling. Beautiful snap suplex there by Stephen Dunn. Now Dunn firing those shots away onto Rex King. Sends them to the corner.
Oh, caught with a big elbow coming off and a neck breaker. Dunn is in real trouble here on the hands of Rex King. Okay, King has been awfully impressive since coming in here just a few weeks ago as a surprise.
King now going to the outside, going to climb up to the
little early for this kind of move.
Top rope, going to come off now. Oh, catches him with an elbow.
He really caught him across the chest with that. That could have knocked the wind out of Steve Dunn.
Now setting Stephen Dunn up, going to send him to the far side. Tries for the clothesline, but misses. Then he was going for the leapfrog, but Dunn caught him, slams him down.
Beautiful powerbomb. Wait a minute, PG-13 have hit the ring. What's going on here? Wait, they're going after both of them. All right, here comes Paul Diamond into the ring now. We need some help out here. But look, this is the triple threat right now, all of a sudden. Got Paul Diamond out here going against Wolfie D. Rex King in the corner. Here comes Flash Flanagan. All right, now the sides are evened up finally, Tony. I'll tell you, we're getting a piece of that triple threat that's going to be at the big one. This is exciting.
PG-13 came in. Paul Diamond and Rex King out and Flash Flanagan and Stephen Dunn. Stephen Dunn's going to get the win by disqualification, but man.
Well, I'll tell you.
The tag team situation here in the USWA is heating up with these three teams.
You know, we better just, my feeling, we just better get out of here because I know we got a lot more to do.
Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Get it on at Greg's Store for Men. Greg's is all that and a lot more. It's the best place in Memphis to get your fashion on with the biggest brand names in the business. Get hooked up for school, a show, a special occasion, or for just chilling. Greg's is down with a large selection of shirts, shorts, jeans, caps, and all the latest athletic shoes and hikers. So don't take long. Go on and get it on at all Greg's locations.
At the Happy Hawker, you'll find all kinds of merchandise at incredible savings. If you like to pay reasonable prices when you buy jewelry, diamonds, musical instruments, cameras, TVs, VCRs, tools, and guns. If you're the kind of person who really searches for just the right gift at just the right price, then you may make a great pawn shopper. Need cash? See us for the lowest rates on loans with the area's only drive-in loan department. Visit either Happy Hawker location, 975 East Parkway South, or our new superstore at 299 North Cleveland.
Looking for some fast action fun this Labor Day weekend? Then make tracks to Southland Greyhound Park for a weekend of big winning excitement. You'll enjoy Super Kennel Club specials all weekend long, and Monday you'll thrill to live doubleheader Greyhound action. Plus, during the Monday Labor Day matinee, five lucky patrons will win a cash prize equal to their weekly paycheck, up to $500 cash. Don't miss 1 second of the fast action fun this Labor Day weekend at Southland Greyhound Park, your action attraction.
It's the four-day Labor Day sales blitz at Graceland Dodge. The big push is on with huge end-of-summer savings on every 97 Dodge. Save up to $2,000 on Neons, $3,000 on Intrepids, and $3,500 on trucks. Over 120 97s to choose from, plus a monster used inventory. Take the money and run with Chrysler cashback options, or super low financing could save you as much as $100 on your monthly payment. Hurry to Graceland Dodge this weekend, still at I-240 and Elvis Presley Boulevard.
Main event time today on Championship Wrestling coming up, and our next match is going to feature Jerry the King Lawler in here to take on the Massive Doomsday. We're waiting the arrival of our participants in this contest. Jerry the King Lawler taking on Doomsday has the making of a fine match, Bill.
Well, and I wouldn't want to be Doomsday at this point. The King is obviously very upset. He's already been into it today a couple of... Well, here comes the Massive Doomsday, and my God, this guy's impressive.
The USWA Heavyweight Champion, Doomsday, 313 pounds wrestling out of the wastelands. This is a non-title match, want to point that out, and it is too the expiration of our time. His opponent, wrestling out of Memphis, Tennessee, 242 pounds, Jerry the King Lawler, in action today against the Massive Doomsday.
And they're ready to go here.
Bell's gone, we're underway. The King, Jerry Lawler.
You know, I don't know why he's allowed to wear that hockey mask in the ring. I can't imagine there's a real reason for him to be allowed to wear it, and that's really not fair. But Doomsday going right after Lawler, has him with a big choke and forces him into the corner turnbuckle. Oh, big kick to the stomach, punches to the face.
We are running low on our time, so we don't know how much of this match we're going to be able to bring you. This is one fall or to the expiration of our time. Doomsday with Lawler rams his head into that top turnbuckle.
Now, if I were Jerry Lawler, I'd just be trying to survive right here against this big man. There's not much time left. The title's not on the line, although you never know with the King. Oh, caught in the corner with a big, big forearm.
Jerry the King Lawler has made his whole career out of beating guys that are bigger than him. They come in here and they think, well, Jerry Lawler doesn't have a lot of size on him. I'm a lot bigger than him. I'm going to take him down. But Jerry the King Lawler has made a career out of beating bigger men.
Well, you could hear that last shot all the way across this area. This is already getting out of hand. Lawler really hasn't had a chance to get going. And quite honestly, he's been involved in it so many times today, I have to think he's tired going into this. And Doomsday's a fresh man coming right out of the back.
We have just under 2 minutes of time remaining in this expiration of time match. 2 minutes remaining. Doomsday now just laying in with those chops and then follows up with that big boot.
All right. Lawler finally is able to get a blow in, and that strap is already pulled down, and Lawler's ready to take him to school.
The King laying those fists in.
Wait a minute. Here comes Dreamer and Bueller. Wait a minute. This is uncalled for, Tony. And a DDT on Lawler. Wait a minute. We need some help out here. Get Tommy Dreamer out of here.
Tommy Dreamer has returned to the scene once
again. Oh, no, that's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. Putting the ECW banner over the King, Jerry Lawler. Could we get somebody from the back to get these guys out of the ring? Here comes the icon, Dutch Mantel.
Mantel hits the ring, attacking
Tommy
Dreamer.
There you go. And now Team Icon is taking it to Tommy Dreamer. About time somebody stood up for USWA. We're almost out of time. We have just a little bit of time here going to break.
We have to jump in and take a quick break, fans. We will be back with more Championship Wrestling.
Hopefully we can get this thing cleared up, Tony.
Stay with us.
This one is big.
That's right, Clarence. It's the big factory-authorized clearance of big Ford trucks.
Hand them on. Move them out.
We are. Now only $239 a month can put you in an F-150.
Motor Trend's Truck of the Year.
Or get low two-down financing for 48 months and save over $1,600 in finance charges on a Ford Ranger.
And it's built Ford tough.
Yippee-ki-yay, little Clarence, and head on down to your local Ford dealer during Ford's factory-authorized clearance. Hit it, partner.
I'm crazy about a Ford truck.
It's home cover-up time at Curlow Construction, and it's your chance to uncover big savings on the improvements your home needs. Right now, save up to $300 on Curlow's best 20-year asphalt fiberglass shingle roof. Save up to $800 on low-maintenance weather-beating siding. Call this number right now for a free, no-obligation home improvement estimate. And with 100% bank rate financing and no money down, Curlow has you covered. Take advantage of home cover-up specials from Curlow Construction, Memphis' number one home improvement company.
Wake up, Marvin. Relax. It's only me. Shame on you. For good things come to those who wait. For my soft buns, my beef, and my steamy onions come together in sweet harmony. They're still talking about the way you peeled out of the parking lot. Listen to the crystal.
You know, I've been in Memphis a long time. Bill Blake Insurance has, too. If you have never checked out the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance, then you're missing a Memphis tradition. Respect, service, and good value is part of doing business at Bill Blake Insurance.
Buying car insurance can be confusing, but not at Bill Blake Insurance. They can answer all your questions, and you only make one payment per month.
I sing the blues all over the world, but I always come home, and I always see the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance. At Bill Blake Insurance, he's from Memphis.
Tony Friedman back on the USWA with Stacy and Bill Behrens. Today is the final edition of Saturday Morning Wrestling. After 30 years, Saturday Morning Wrestling draws to a close today. However, the USWA lives on Saturdays at midnight right here on WMC
And don't
TV
forget
5.
That Sunday 3 p.m. time period. It looks like we got a little bit of a party going on here. Stacy, thank you. Oh, my God.
Confetti and balloons dropping down.
Well, I tell you, we do have a party here. I'll tell you, but it's always a party in the USWA where we have more action in any one program than any wrestling program in the United States. And we plan to continue that as we head into the next year and into the next decade. I'll tell you, this is exciting. We've got, we had a big card here today, obviously. We had Tommy Rich appear for the first time on television over Mike Samples. We had the premiere of the Colorado Kid, who was victorious in his match.
Bill, I want to jump in real quick. We're having a party here in the studio, but tomorrow night's going to be a party at the Big One Expo Center right there at I-40 Hollywood Exit Number 5, and I want to invite everyone out in the Memphis and the Mid-South area tomorrow night. It all kicks off at 7:30, but you're going to see that free match between Brian Christopher and Billy Joe Travis in the parking lot in a cage. That's going to kick off tomorrow
at 6:30. The King, Dundee, Tommy Dreamer, Dutch Mantell, we've got them all out there. This is going to be amazing. There's never been anything like it at the Big One. Get down there early. Get those ringside seats.
We will see you for Championship Wrestling this Saturday at midnight for the first ever Midnight Wrestling this Saturday at midnight. For Bill Behrens, Stacy, I'm Tony Friedman. Have a great weekend, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow night at the Big One.
Bye-bye, everyone.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.